this year is first world problems as a fighter. That's why I always hope that my wife does my washing. Because I know this will be folded up, ready to go.
Yeah, one day we can be on top of the world, 3 years dominant champion, and the next day it can be taken all away from you. With Kirill, there's no difference. I'm gonna come in there, I'm gonna do my thing, entertain the crowd, but most importantly, get that W. Being in his shoes, man, for real. I've been in his shoes. I looked at all the other guys that were, yeah, my age now, and I kind of was that young man mentality where I thought I was invincible. At the end of the day, you can talk all he wants, man, because come Friday night when those cage door closes, that's it. All the talking's done.
Если вы посмотрите мои бои, то убедитесь в том, что я могу заканчивать и нокаутами, и сабмишинами. Поэтому я считаю, в эту пятницу я вас удивлю досрочной победой. Я хочу передать Украине, чтобы ждали мою победу. Это будет для вас, для Украины, для моего народа, для семьи. Я с вами, и слава Украине, героям слава.
70.1
for the next wave. Fight on, the fight on, man. That's what we want.
Perfect.
Congratulations for making weight. Tomorrow's the real test.
I put my striking against anybody in MMA on the planet. So if you had the almighty of fighting, they're 10 out of 10 in all those categories. 10 out of 10 grappler, 10 out of 10 striker. That's the way it works. And that's what we're all trying, striving to get to. And that's why I'm working on grappling every day. I work on my grappling more than my striking, because it needs it. I'm fighting this man because he is the toughest test I can see right now. So I need that to happen. But with that said and done, yeah, let's go get some training in. Like, you know, like, these guys are good for a reason. Maybe I can help him with some striking. Maybe he can help me with some grappling. But that's later. I'll try to kill you on Friday. You try to kill me on Friday. We'll figure that out afterwards.
Just put it on. Tell me if it's tight enough for you.
Did I go hit it?
Yeah.
Oh, I gotta move. Oh, it's so tight.
And then you hit fight, and then you can choose who you want to fight.
Okay. Punch him in the This is tight. Oh my god.
I think most people associate Gary with the idea of movement. He's famous as a scrambler who always seems to find a way to get into submission holds. The highest object of jiu-jitsu is submission. You want to make your opponent submit. Gary is one of those guys who come out and he will fight like a cat, standing ground, top, bottom, scramble, 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 and suddenly there's a submission hold. It comes seemingly out of nowhere. That's more or less what he's most well known for in the sport of grappling.
What do I think of Thon as a fighter? I think he's like an assassin as opposed to a murderer. An assassin is, there's a lot of planning ahead of time and precision, and you want to be able to get in and out without getting caught. There's a certain art to the assassin. Despite the fact that they're both of their jobs is to kill, in a sense, there's a lot more artfulness. And I think Thon Lee is very artful in his striking. Take this, Thon. Yeah, the original plan for this fight was to have like medium to long length hair, but yeah, it didn't really work out so well. The beginning problem was that I got a haircut that was just god awful. This is on my Instagram if you guys want to take a look. It was pretty bad, so I just decided to buzz my hair after that, and we've cascaded to full baldness at this point.
All right, thank you.
After watching CJ Olenike today, I feel so confident, I feel so strong. I said, come for this guy. He looked completely different guy, you know what I mean? Like, before he talked a lot, but was there, he was very, like, I don't know, humble, or I don't know what, you know what I mean? It was weird.
Gosh, I go beat this rack.
You need to win for the fight, huh?
Yeah.
Hey! Yeah, you passed the... You beat him. Yeah.
No,
you
passed
him.
He have power. They say he have power. I don't know about that. what I'm all about is, I don't care, I will be that guy, but I want to beat that Tan Lee. Hey, Mart. Don't forget, I have stuff in my room, bro.
Yeah, I'll get it from you. Okay,
take care.
Thank you, man.
Martin, you're gonna.
Good to see you.
Top
yeah, yeah, let's see. Let's
talk.
See you.
No,
let's see you.
Interview first.
Good. Let's see you.
What is punching machine?
Martin's my brother.
Oh, oh, oh. Oh, damn, nah, I can't beat that.
Come on, you can do it.
No way, man.
Come on. Don't give up like easily. Come on. Try a little bit. Try this. Not bad.
Watch this last one, right?
Yeah. Oh.
It's much better. I said it's much better. It became lighter. I don't really care.
A gente fica, eu fiquei meio frustrado, né, no começo, porque a gente treina muito, se dedica muito, né, dieta. Então, você receber a notícia que não vai lutar é um pouco frustrante, mas a gente tem que entender que não está sob o nosso controle, né, é algo que não está em nossas mãos. Então, mantive a cabeça erguida e retornei aos treinos até que remarcaram a próxima data. Então, na verdade, eu tô animado, né, por ser a luta do título. Com certeza, vencer, ganhar o cinturão é uma alegria muito grande para mim. E vencer um cara como o Bibiano, né, que tem um histórico de luta aí sensacional, um cara que vem anos aí como campeão, e vencer um mestre de jiu-jitsu aí, para mim, será uma satisfação grande também. Não só o título, mas também vencendo um cara como ele.
John Lineker! Bibiano Hernandez!
Tan Lee leaves, missing one of his limbs.
Wow!
I like it. I like the confidence. I like the spryness. Obviously, I think it's going to go on the other side of the coin, and I think he'll be asleep at the end of this.